Hi guys, this is Larissa with Be You Beautiful One. Welcome to my channel. I'm so glad that you're here. I'm excited to share with you my setup for August the 9th through the 15th in my scripture writing planner. For this particular season, I'm using a horizontal planner. Absolutely love it because it's a clean slate and easy to write on. So the kits that I am going to utilize are the One in a Million kit from Print, Pray, Slay. And I have a link down below that you can utilize that will help you to save on your purchase. You click on the link, the discount code is automatically in the cart. Or you can just write down my discount code and save it for anytime you want to use it. But I'm using the One in a Million printable kit, which I really love, and I'm so excited to share with you about it. In addition to that, I'm going to use a doll from the Prayer Doll Journaling Kit number 4. And I really love the dolls on here, and I just felt that one in particular would go great with this particular kit. And so here we go. I'm going to go ahead and get started now. Okay, so I have already cut out the various elements from the pages that I am going to be using from the kit. So I've already cut out the one page for the One in a Million kit, as well as the doll that I chose. And also, here are the scriptures that are featured in the One in a Million kit. Matthew 18 verses 10 through 14, and Luke chapter 15, verses 3 through 7. Matthew 18, 10 through 14, and Luke chapter 15, verses 3 through 7, which I will share with you as I go along here. And I'm just like really trying to get outside of my normal type of setup. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some of these distress outside stamps that I purchased earlier this year that I have not yet used. I do know how to technically like use my ink pad with stamps, but the freehand style I'm still trying to figure out, but I really have not played with it enough to yet feel comfortable with it. And so I'm just going to take one of these stampers that I have and one of the brushes that I've had that I've just been collecting and observing different creators and how they use their stamps and these tools to just change up things. And so that's what I want to do here. So I'm just taking this stamper. It's a circle pad. It's like a Velcro pad that you could change out. And it's part of the Tim Holtz collection. And I'm taking like a sheet of paper, printer paper, and just putting it in back of my planner page just to help protect the other pages from accidentally getting ink on there. And hopefully that will work, because I'm starting to find out that if I stamp a certain way around the edges of the pages that I may possibly get something on the other side of the pages, but I'm not going to worry about that. I'm just going to go with the flow and see what I can create. Now, again, I'm new to this particular style of using an ink pad. And so I've only done it, I want to say probably less than 10 times over the past year. So you'll see me mess up. You'll see me be like, Larissa, that ain't cute. But you know, once you put ink on your planner pages, that's it. Unless I want to create a whole new planner page, which I don't. I'm just going to see this all the way through. But basically with this circle dabber, it's really easy if you blend it out as you go along, because this particular ink doesn't settle fast. It gives you enough time to sort of blend out the ink. And so I'm primarily using circular motion, dabbing motions, and you'll just see me sort of using a little bit of everything right now because I'm figuring it out. But I like the dabbing motion where it's sort of leaving like the little splotches. To me, that sort of looks like the watermelon, where it's just that texture kind of feel minus the seed. So, and then I had accidentally put too much of the red ink on my stamper, and so I just blotted out on that piece of paper, and then I tried to see if maybe I could pick up some of the ink from the paper to try to just put it on my planner pages. Slightly worked, but I think I waited too long to do that. If I would have did it right away, you know, no problem. But again, just trying different things out, so I'm stepping outside of my box. Now, I'm going to be forthright with you. Honestly, I think this looks a mess. And it goes back to bless this mess. So. But I do like how it turned out in the end. And again, it's just part of having fun and enjoying the process of putting something together that helps you through the process of enjoying studying God's word and so forth. And there are so many different things that you could pick up from using the different inks and the different tools, from the stickers and so forth, and meditate and reflect on how God works through all of that, because God is a creative God. God is not a stale God. God breathed his creative spirit into those who were building his place of worship, the tent of the tabernacle, you know, and they were creative because God gave them that creativity. So don't shy from that. Explore your creativity that God has placed in you, and let it give him glory and honor. So God, I'm giving you glory and honor through this particular stamping episode. So anywho, I decided to go ahead and proceed. I absolutely love this doll. It has the pink and the yellow in there, and I thought that it would just be a good doll to work with this particular kit. I did take my white out and whited out the dates so that the dates wouldn't hinder with the doll itself. And then I love that quote, "I'm one in a million," which I'm about to get to, because when I saw this particular kit, I was like, now what is this, you know? How does this reflect God's word? So I was really happy to see it come together. And this washi tape that I'm using, and I wanted to really use this washi tape. I've had it for a year now. It's from the Paper House. It's a Paper House Studio website. They had like a big warehouse sale on washi tape, and this was a really pretty watermelon one. It has the scent and the fragrance with it, and so I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna use this in this particular setup, even though it's more of a deeper, darker red than the rest of the kit. But that's okay, we're going with it, right? And so let's talk about this one in a million. So one of the scriptures that is a part of this kit is Matthew 18 verses 10 through 14. And this brought me right back to the love of God, the awesomeness of God. The thing that makes God God is that he loves beyond what we can comprehend or even phantom, because he's just love, you know? And because he loved me so much, God will leave, will seek me, will go find me, will go after me, and pull me into his protective flock. And in the Bible, it uses the illustration of a shepherd and a sheep, and how the shepherd is responsible for an entire flock. But when one gets away from the flock, whether it's intentional or not, he will leave the 99 and go get that one sheep and rescue it from harm and danger, and bring it back into fold, into his community, into his family, into under his protection, love, guidance, and provision. And so I really love that. And so Matthew 18, verse 10, sorry, I flipped off the page here. It says, beware that you don't look down on any of these little ones, for I tell you that in heaven, their angels are always in the presence of my heavenly Father. If a man has 100 sheep and one of them wanders away, what will he do? Won't he leave the 99 others on the hills and go out and search for the one that was lost, that is lost? And if he finds it, I tell you the truth, he will rejoice over it more than over the 99 that didn't wander away. In the same way, it is not my heavenly Father's will that even one of these little ones should perish. So you, as a child of God, are precious to him, right? And there are going to be times, seasons in our lives where we go through things where our faith may not be as strong as it needs to be, and we tend to wander away from God, right? We get further away from his voice, and the further we get away from his voice, we get lost along the way, or maybe we haven't even found his voice yet. God loves us so much that he will do things to draw us close to him and to help us to get on the right path, to decide him as our Lord and Savior. And so I love that about God, that he loves me so much that he sent his only begotten son to die for me, to save me, to rescue me. That is the very essence of who God is, you know? And he waits patiently for us to turn our attention back to him. Isn't God good? I just love that. And so you are that one. You are that one out of 100 that God will run after and find you and rescue you and save you and put you under his protection, under his guidance, and provide for you and fight your enemies off of you. No wolf is going to come and attack you, because he is your avenger. He is your savior, your protector. So I love that. And so on this particular setup, I'll go back to this. I love this watermelon cross, and I just wanted to put that right there alongside of the page, and that gives me ample room to still write. And the paper that I use is a paper that I can write on top in case I do need more room. I try not to write on top of my stickers because that's just me. But if I need to, I will. I put the little watermelon popsicle up at the top, and some of the watermelons I just sprinkle around the both of the pages, as well as a watermelon cone up there towards the top right. And again, I just put some of the watermelon washi tape on the top and bottom, and then just a little strip underneath the I am one in a million phrase. And then probably below that, I'm going to write out a portion of this particular scripture, either from Matthew or from Luke. So I really like how this layout came out after everything was put together. It's very different for me, but still, yet I'm looking forward to writing in it throughout the week. Stay tuned. At towards the end of this clip, I will insert my spread after pen from last week, and I hope that you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, turn on your notification bell, and until the next time, thank you so much for joining me. God bless you. God keep you. Bye-bye. All right, guys, here is my after pin for my setup from last week. I absolutely love The sticker kit that I used for this week, it was a constant reminder of seeking after God, of creating a thirst for Him by getting into my word, prayer, worship, and praise, and having a heart of thanksgiving. And so I absolutely love how the spread turned out. Yes, I do have two ink colors. The one page is primarily what I did at work during like my lunch hour. I was taking time out to write the scriptures out and to do a little bit of studying. And I honestly did not like the pen that I had at work, and I'm just returning back to work into the building, so I don't have all of my favorite pens there yet, but I wanted to use that time to do my scripture writing. And so when I brought my planner home for the weekend, I did not bring that pen that I used at work, and so I grabbed a different pen and one of my favorite pens, and it was not in blue ink, and I just didn't care. I wanted to write well and feel well while I was writing, so that's why you see two ink colors. For this Saturday and Sunday, the scripture writing plan only does 5 days of the week, and so I took this area here to write out a scripture, not a scripture, but a verse from one of my favorite songs that I learned as a kid. Is called "I'm Available to You," and it basically says, "God, I want you to fill me up. I'm pouring out whatever is not of you, and I am wanting to be filled of you. I want you to fill me up with your presence so that I can do all the things that you want me to do, using everything that you have given to me, including my eyes, my ears, my hands, my voice, so that you can use them as you please. Lord, I am available to you." So I love that song. If I remember, I will try to link it down below in the comment area so that you have a reference to this particular song. It's a great worship song and of honoring God and recognizing Him as Lord of Lord and King of King over your life, and giving yourself to Him on a day-to-day basis. So love that. That's all that I have. Thank you so much for joining me. Don't forget to like, subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and also check out my print price link to save on your purchases. Thank you. Bye-bye.